personal connection. It's very personal. I live in Clevedon in North Somerset. I knew Kate in the last year of her life. And Singe, from then on, our kids, my boys Tom and Joe, go to the same school as Reef and Finn did at the time. So I was right there when it was all happening, and actually seeing the list become this kind of news phenomenon, then seeing the book publishers take interest, and at that time, so did film producers. And Singe was like, "Well, you do films, you make it." And I said, "You know what? I feel I'm probably too close, and also movies can mess this up. They often do." I said, "I'll stand by you, and I'll give you the rules to put down to stop those gannetting film producers from getting it wrong." And in the period when he was writing the book with Rachel Murphy, I was kind of working on these rules and realizing actually there were rules for me. There were me understanding how I could tell it. And because of my personal connection, that was all about honoring a certain privacy to them, a certain story which the film doesn't feature that much because it's the story of Reef, their boy who suffered from cancer himself. It wasn't ours to tell. It's not our story to tell. He's there to tell it himself one day if he wants to. And just certain things about Kate, which was realizing that the list was not a bucket list. And that's what I think is it's not a bucket list. It's not things she wants to do. It's how she decides to help those around her who are going to be left behind and how she puts herself. And that that was the biggest personal connection. When I realized that going through the list, when I realized it was her manifesto, her memorial for herself, that's what drew me in, because there was Kate. There was Kate in her writings. And I think that was also the challenge, is presenting the woman who couldn't be here to tell her own story, and presenting her in a way that honoured her, made people love her, and yet still make a movie from this and still have a movie with the beats that you expect. And that meant getting the best people to be in the film.
I think, it's every parent's worst nightmare, isn't it, for something to happen to your child. And you would say, all of us would say, yeah, I would swap and places, and Kate did, didn't she? And then the fact that she did swap places, but prepared for the future by leaving these notes so that she would be part of their lives even when she wasn't there. I find that incredibly moving. I think Kate was remarkable. I think their love for each other is remarkable. I think the family love is remarkable, and the film is a celebration of that. I think her generosity of spirit, I think in thinking about what the right thing to do for Singe and for the boys, even when she wasn't going to be there, I find it that incredibly moving. And preparing for it, I sat with Singe in a pub for a couple of hours and asked him to talk me through every scene in the film, where Kate was emotionally and physically, which is a difficult thing to ask someone to talk about. But Singe was so generous and open to that. And so we sat there and we cried for a couple of hours. And then I had to go back to work. And he said that someone came up to him in the pub and said, "Have you just broken up with that girl?" but yes, Singe was my, who I turned to ask about Kate. And it's very different because Rafe could actually, see Singe at the breakfast table every day and pick up characteristics of him. And I didn't have that. I relied on Singe, and I relied on the book, and I relied on Niall, who knew the family as well. So I felt very well supported in that, but a huge responsibility as
well. You did.
Well.
We had lots of conversations about you feeling that responsibility, that you felt this is Kate. This isn't about acting. It's not about performance. Yeah. It's about being Kate and representing her for as long as the film lasts.
Absolutely.
Out there.
Absolutely. And because it was such an emotional piece to film, everyone was very emotional on it. And sometimes you reminded me, actually, that I got cross with my own emotions coming through.
Yeah, you did.
Because it was hard not to. And making sure it was Kate's emotions, not Emilia's emotions.
The big thing was filming the speech. That was the big moment. Yeah. You wanted to get through the speech without crying. We had a conversation about it. You said, but Kate wouldn't have cried. But actually, Kate didn't write the list in one go. It was over a period of months. If Kate had written that list, all in one go, I'm sure she would have been exactly as you were.
Yeah.
So what I think what's powerful about that scene, other than your performance at that moment, which is amazing, what's powerful is your battle against those emotions, because that's actually what Kate had to do across the 18 months that she was falling ill and then passing at the end of it. She was battling those emotions in order to see ahead and give her husband those tools.
Yeah.
You know.
Wow, his performance is, I think, breathtaking, amazing. How a smile can light up a screen is incredible, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, yes, Rafe is amazing because he is so relaxed on camera and he improvises and his accent is extraordinary. So what happens is you just instantly fall into a sort of other reality. And it was really important, I think, working with children as well, that we could do that. And Matty and Wilsey, who play Reef and Finn, were amazing at sort of accepting that we were sort of their surrogate parents for that month. And so were James and Verity, who are their real parents, allowed that to happen. So within each day, when we were on camera, off camera, we were sort of a family and stuck to that for the duration of the filming period.